had such fun. We're all sitting around here going, ribbit, ribbit. And what did you do when those two frogs kissed each other? All the sound effects. Did you actually have to do those sound effects in the studio?
Yes, for the record, yeah. They couldn't find anyone else who could kiss like I could.
What about the fish in the middle who goes, rawr, rawr, that one? Who's that?
That's me again, yes. It's me. It's a cheap record.
He's admitting it all.
Yeah.
Do you mind if I digress a minute and just remember those pictures we were looking at of Philip?
Yes.
Well, I had this idea. See, that one had the top half of his head on, and that was the chin. And I thought if you put them together like this, you've got a sort of Arthur Mallard under the water. Haven't you? Do you like that?
Much.
That's quite good, I think. That's about the most flattering bit I've ever had. Anyway. What are you doing next, Paul, after you've finished here, next week? What are you doing?
What am I doing? Well, funnily enough, I'm going to work with George Martin and do a new Rupert song next week.
Any clues? Any
well,
clues about
it's just a new song. It's for... We're hoping to do the kind of feature of the whole full-length film of Rupert. So it's a new song for that.
So what do you do with a project like that? Are you building up the songs, little animation, little films, and then you're going to put them all together, or what?
Well, really what we're doing, we're just kind of trying out this new song, and then we'll probably sort of start working on the film after that. But it's really just to keep moving rather than sort of keep thinking about the script endlessly, you know.
Mm. And also giving you time to do lots of other things
in the meantime, like come on shows like this.
Come on, going live.
I know,
we're jolly glad that you did. We've got the call on line one.
Have we? Right.
As we speak, Julia is waiting to speak to us. Julia, what's your question for Paul?
Hello, Paul.
Hi, Julia.
Paul, if you woke up on Christmas morning and found that somebody had bought you a time machine, which part of your life would you like to go back to?
Ooh. Which part of my life would I like to go back to? Oh, dear.
Does it have to be back? Do you have to be going back, Julia?
Well, we can go forward if you
can
want.
Can it go forward as well?
Yeah, if you want.
I think I'll stick with back for the time being, if you don't mind, Sarah. Meeting the Queen at the Royal Command performance, the bit where she said to me, she said, where are you playing tomorrow night? And I said, Slough, Mum. And she said, oh, that's just near us.
Did she offer to invite you in for some cocoa or anything like that?
No, I did. She didn't actually invite us for the cocoa and stuff, but it was more the rum and drambuie.
Good Lord. Now we know. Thanks for that question, Julia. Brilliant.
Yeah.
I love you. And so do Natasha, Cheska, Lucy, Rebecca and Fiona. So could you blow a kiss to us, please?
Wow.
Lots of love in your direction.
Look at this. Isn't that great, eh?
Brilliant. Thanks a lot, Julia. Now, who's next? Line four. We've got Tamsin, I think.
Hello.
Hello, Tamsin.
Hello.
Are you speechless
now? How long did it take you to write the song?
To write the frog song?
Yes.
It actually didn't take very long, really. It took longer to make the record and do all the arrangements and do all the bits like the kissing and all the little bits Sarah was talking about. But actually writing it, it just took one day, just a few hours one day.
But what about other songs? I mean, do they all take you...
I keep getting caught up in my little
aerial.
Do you
want to put your aerial down?
All right. No, I've got to keep my aerial up.
Keep the aerial
up. At all times.
Keep the aerial up at all
times. Got to. Ever ready.
What about other songs, Paul? Does it always take you that amount of time to write a song, or do they come to you...?
No, well, if you're lucky, you know, writing a song can be very quick. Sometimes some of the nice ones just come to you very quickly. But if you're unlucky, they can take weeks, really. Sometimes the words take a long time to come and you've got the tune. And sometimes it can be the other way around. You get the words and then the tune takes a long time.
What about Once Upon a Long Ago? How did that all happen?
That was quite a quick one. Quite a quickie.
Mm-hmm.
That took about a day to actually write and then another day to sort of finish the words off.
So there you are. Tamsin, thank you very much.
Tamsin.
Is it line three next we've got?
Hello,
Lindsay.
Hi.
You now live a very quiet life in Scotland.
Yeah.
Have you ever thought of retracing your roots back to Liverpool?
How do you mean?
Well, to see your old friends.
Oh, yeah. No, I do go back to Liverpool to see all my old friends and my relatives and stuff. I go up, you know, to just kind of touch base and stuff. But I must admit, I don't go up as much as I used to because my dad's no longer alive and I used to mainly go up to sort of see him a lot, you know. But I do get up, and I've got millions of cousins. In fact, there's some of them going to be watching now. Hi, cousins. Si, Liz, millions of them. I'm not going to get into mentioning them, but they're all watching right now.
Cool.
Yeah?
My mum, when she was 14, she queued up all night to see you, so could you blow her a big kiss?
Should I blow your mum a kiss?
Yes.
Okay, Mum.
Oh, there's kissing going on this morning.
This is terrible, isn't it? Eh? Yeah.
Good Lord. Line five, next. Who's on line five?
James.
James, are you there?
Yes.
Morning.
Morning.
Hi, James.
Hello, Paul.
I knew you when you were an actor. Go on. What's your question?
Would you like to play in a band with your children when they are older?
Yeah, that'd be lovely, actually. Yeah, sometimes when we're at home, you know, the kids sort of get and bang drums and sort of play instruments and stuff, and we do little bits and pieces together, and it's great fun. And I have often wondered, you know, when they grow up, if they wanted to be in a band, it'd be great
to
have
them.
Well,
I'm going to ask one right now, actually. Excuse me. There's a young
man
sitting
here. We've got one of them right
here.
Can
we introduce this young man to the world? Can we move over? He's right here, next here, over here. There we are.
There he is, that's my son, James, in
James.
Fact. James.
Take the phone and tell this young man, also called James, whether you want to be in a band.
Yes.
What would you like to play?
Guitar.
Like Dad?
Guitar, yeah.
Are you left-handed?
Oh. No, he's right-handed, yeah. But he liked guitar ever since he saw Back to the Future.
With Michael J. Fox?
Yeah.
That was brilliant, wasn't it?
And we played Johnny B. Goode together. You ought to hear it. It's hip.
I think I'm going to ask if we can hear that next time, maybe. Definitely.
Okay, we'll give us time to practice
time to practice, then we're getting you back for that one. Now, we've got Denise on line six now. Thanks for that call, James. Denise, good morning.
Hello.
Hello.
Paul, who were your childhood heroes in the music world and in the film world?
Well, in the film world, first of all, I like Fred Astaire. You know the great dancer, Fred Astaire? I love him, and I actually love his voice too. He sings a song called Cheek to Cheek, which is one of my favorites. But more recently, I like the rock and rollers like Elvis. I liked Elvis Presley in his early days a lot. I like Fats Domino, I like Jerry Lee Lewis, I like Chuck Berry, Carl Perkins. There's a big long list which I won't bore you with now. Okay.
I actually heard Little Richard telling a story.
And Little Richard, yeah.
Little Richard telling a story about teaching Paul about going, like this.
That's right. He tells everyone that
story.
Is
it true or not?
It's not true at all.
Chance to put a story right.
It's not
Thank you very much for the call. Can we have a chance to put another story right here?
Yes.
Something
yes,
that
Sarah.
I'd like to know about.
Who's Sarah going out with? No, we know that one. Okay.
No, you know that one.
We know that one.
No, it's another story. Another story about you doing a video.
Yes.
With young George and young Ringo.
Oh, yes, that's right. Yeah.
I mean, any chance of that?
Well, actually, George asked me the other night to be in his video. And then I read in the paper the next morning that I was doing it. I hadn't actually answered whether I was going to do it or not. The newspaper seemed to know that I was. And then I saw George the night after, and he said, he didn't even know anything about it. So I think it was made up. That's your question. It's you I'm talking to now, isn't it? Not out there.
Well, probably out there as well, because quite a lot of people I know have been asking that anyway.
Yeah, I'd like to be in his video. I'd like to play the part of the walrus with a big mask over my head, you know, and be very... walrusy about the whole thing, yes.
If you're not being a frog, you're being a walrus.
I don't know. There's no stopping him.
I'm afraid that's all the calls we've got time for this morning, but we have got this lovely video here. Once upon a long ago, a nice picture of Paulie on the front there.
Yeah, aye.
And we're going to be giving that away, but you have to come up with an answer to a question first. What's the question, Paulie?
Which is, what national newspaper does Rupert appear in? Very hard, that one. Very difficult question.
Answers on a postcard to Going Live, BBC TV, London W12, 8QT. Well, the boys are standing by. Linda and the band are over there. Nice to see you.
Nice
Welcome.
To see you.
They're all there, just warming their fingers up, ready for the number. And Trev and Simon are fulfilling a lifetime's ambition.
See you later, sir.
They're handing over your guitar to you. Nice to talk to you, Paul.
Oops, see you later.
Thank
you, sir. Very
Paul McCartney, Christmas single, Once Upon a Long Ago. When they've just flexed their fingers, they'll be ready to start, I'm sure. Here it is.
Picking up scales and broken chords, puppy dog tails in the House of Lords. Tell me, darling, what can it mean? Making up moons in a minor key. What are those tunes got to do with me? Tell me, darling, where have you been? Once upon a long ago, children said,
toys, Curiosity Killed the Cat, there's all
sorts.
And a big
celebrity double dare, so don't miss it. Thanks, Tom.
Thank you, Tom.
Paul,
thank you very much. Thanks to all our guests. Goodbye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.